Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we begin this most solemn of celebrations, the Easter Vigil, we will begin with the blessing and the lighting of the Easter candle. I encourage everyone watching us at home, if you want to participate more fully in these festivities, turn down the lights in your house. And if you have candles, have them ready. For after we light the Easter candle, we will have our candles lit here in this church, and we'll encourage you to light your candles at home. First, the lines are drawn into the candle. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him, and all ages. To him be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. The candle symbolizes Jesus himself. And there are five nails placed into the Christ candle, symbolizing the five marks, the five wounds of our Lord. By his holy, Christ the Lord, guard us and protect us. Amen.
Amen.
May the light of Christ, rising in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds. Amen.
Amen.
Now we will light the Christ candle. Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his peoples, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this pastoral work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. At this time, if you want, you can leave your candles lit, turn on a few lights, let's begin our readings.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus, evening came, and morning followed, the first day.
Followed the third day. You've been
let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days, and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth. And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day.
Seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all
heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Please rise and let us pray. Israel's birthright through Christ.
says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without pain and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not. And nations that knew you not shall run to you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above yours, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In a moment, we are going to sing the great Christian hymn, The Glory, our song of joy. And during that time, our altar candles will be lit. All the lights in the church will be turned on. And I encourage you at home, go through the house. Send the kids upstairs down the bay. Light the whole house up. Let's bring light into our neighborhoods.
Consequently, yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise for the proclamation of the gospel. Watching And to all my parishioners and our visitors, I miss you so much. And I thank you for all the prayers you've been sending my way. And know that every day, morning, evening, at my Mass, and throughout the day, I've been praying for you. Today's been a significant day for me personally. Do you have flashbulb memories? Memories where you know exactly where everything was, the smells, the sights. And today, 4 years ago, for me personally, is one of those flashbulb memories. I was at a place called Our Lady of Peace Hospice. And I was at my mother's bed. And this today was the day she died. I on one side, my brother on the other side, holding her hands, my dad beside us. And I thought of this as reading the readings, the women, the Marys, going to the tomb of Jesus. And I thought of all the times now in these 4 years, myself going to the tomb of my mother. And I always expected to be the same. Beautiful grass and flowers. And the Marys went, they expected just there to be the tomb and the stone and nothing. But they get there. And the world is turned upside down. And I thought, man, what if I went to my mother's tomb and it's empty, the dirt is gone, and there's an angel that says, she rose! And I'd run to, just like they did, and the first person I'd run to would be the people who loved my mother most. My father, my brother, my immediate family. And the Marys, they're going to his disciples. Jesus even called them his brothers, the people that loved him most. I don't know what's going to happen with the world, with this virus. I expect, I pray, everyone will be back together again. But one day, whenever it is, I expect to go around to my mother. Maybe even be laid next to her in the ground. In the meantime, I'm here for a purpose. You are here for a purpose. We have the light of Christ in us. And we bring it around to everyone. My mother had that light in her. And if it wasn't for her, I would not have had an encounter with Christ. She brought Christ to me so that now I can bring him to others. And I know there's so many of you at home who have loved ones who have passed from this life to the next. And you miss them too. And you're so thankful for how they brought Jesus to you and gave help instill the seeds of faith in you. But one day the world will be turned upside down for all of us, for our loved ones who have passed. Death doesn't have the last say. And that is our Easter joy. Please rise. On this most solemn night, we would normally bless the water, but we don't have anyone here and no one to baptize. But we will renew our baptismal vows. Most of us, myself included, I think everyone here was baptized as infants. Our parents, our godparents, made these promises on our behalf. But now we make them for ourselves. We recommit ourselves to our faith in Christ. And so this is going to have two parts. I'm going to have first the three questions. Your response will be, I do teach one. The first three, though, they're the rejection ones. and we're going to face the west where the sun sets. This is a very ancient tradition. The Christians will always turn towards the west and set the sun, a sign of darkness. And so let's turn towards the west, and I'm going to ask you three questions. The response again is, I do. First question, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
You better. And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
And now for the positive questions, let's turn towards the east, where the sun rises, the sun symbol of Christ. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary?